best of three. Everybody freaks out and says they're garbage now.
That's it. Secret disband, obviously.
Yeah, the game was exciting. I like a good underdog story, but let's let them get the overall victory first before.
Just a side note,
blow things out of proportion.
Last time they won on their support Nightstalker, they actually did it in combination with the Juggernaut. Small side note to do.
And Toby,
The last time they played Nightstalker support, though, they lost. That wasn't as great as a stat for it, for a fact.
I have seen the Nightstalker support completely just dominate, though. Like, it was yesterday I casted Vega versus OG. OG let them pick the Nightstalker support for solo. That was probably one of the more one-sided victories I've seen.
It is rough if Nightstalker doesn't... Well, if he gets a run and you get that Aghanim's up, then Secret of No Vision, this Mag RP initiator is going to do nothing. They'll see snowballs coming from a mile away. We are maybe not so much. He's a highly maneuverable player on that Wind Ranger. So Blink Daggers, 4-stars kind of style. Even just the Blink Dagger with an Aghanim Scepter is already scary enough.
The thing about that last game, though, that really gives me hope is that despite the fact that... Oh,
yeah, they really want to fight this, because bot lane, you got a battle between Juggernaut as well as the Magnus, but with all the Iron Shells up on top lane, there's no way Secret want to fight into that. Mag will be able to get that early bounty rune, but this means Weeha starting from behind, up against an Ember Spirit who's already got a PMS, and now able to get himself an early salve if he desires. In fact, what do we look at the build for the Ember Spirit mid? You're up against a Wind Ranger. Do you go for tank? Do you go for aggression?
You still go for the standard build overall. It's not like you're going to change things drastically, hero to hero. If you were playing against a Queen of Pain and she was dominating you mid and she was going to get a really fast Orchid, then things might change. But
they're coming for the Darkseer. Support needs to come in from the Nightstalker, but what's he going to do? It's daytime. There's a lot of Iron Shells.
There's three Iron Shells.
And Puppy with the Void. He's taking so much damage, and who's going to die?
Who's going
to
get it?
It's actually first blood to the Nightstalker. He'll end up taking it out. EE will still find that revenge kill onto the Darkseer, but with those Iron Shells and the Void damage, it just gave the edge to Newbie Y.
Alright, so they get first blood.
This actually really hurts too. Like Puppy, okay, he brought an extra Tango to Pilot Eye, because Pilot Eye was out of life, as in consumables.
Yeah, they don't have that much regen left over. The Nightstalker now has boots.
They're coming again.
You can't fight under this, not double Ion Shell. The scary thing though is as soon as, is it Lee? I see Ellie and I know one's Lee.
It's Lee. Lee is
the emoji face. Yeah. Lee. Yeah. As soon as Lee hits level 3 and he gets to the second level of the Ion Shell, then things really start to turn around. So you've got to be pretty worried about that, and somebody's going hype over something.
Relax. We focus on this game for now. There's enough hype in this one.
There really is. And the fact that if Newbie Young can drop it. Team Secret into the lower half of this bracket.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be pretty insane, but...
Yeah, because then they got to go up against either LGD or Cloud9 to opponents where... Well, I don't think it's really possible.
For me, though, the last game, SC was just such a standout player. If he's able to have a similar performance, that'd be great, but... Newbie, Young, what they're worried about right now, or what they should be, is the confidence of their carry player and whether or not he's able to bounce back, because... I don't really like to call out players, but that individual performance was not strong. Like, there were a lot of individual errors, dying to the Roshan, for example, 0-4-3, wasn't able to accomplish too much. He's got to really get back on his feet this game.
Well, it's definitely working out so far. Like, he's equal CS with Eternal Envy, but what's going to give him the space as well as the confidence, like a farm, is the fact that one Pilot Eye is about to die. There's a Surge right now over on Ellie. He just has to keep up with the Tusker. The Void is not off cooldown, he doesn't have mana for it. He's short by 6 mana, and the Iron Shell's not reaching Pilot Eye, so Puppy starts with the Body Block. He does actually have the Shallow Grave, but does he know the timing for it? Now Void will come off cooldown. Nightstalker,
Camille, still gonna go for it.
YOLO. No,
oh, he doesn't get it! 2 health!
He dropped down to 1 at one point, and now it's actually going to be Ellie dying to Puppy up into the tree line. He can't munch in a Tango. He'll fight up against the Dazzle, but it's not strong enough.
That's
rough. That's so rough.
That's pretty tilting. I saw 2 HP, but it had been like half a second after.
But it's the pullback. He had that moment. But he had to commit from the very, very start. The indecision lost him the kill.
All right, you just kind of have to move on from that play and say to yourself, it's not that big of a deal. Let's just move on. These things happen. If one HP, whatever, guys.
Man, if it worked, you'd be looking at Ellie. Like, yeah, he would have died, but coming into this first nighttime, he'd have so much to work with.
He would have
now it's
the
misery. He's still got Skewer Revival, gonna put himself down inside the river. And this gank coming in 15 seconds before the nighttime is coming. So that Void could have done a lot more. He could have actually had, well, not level 4.
The thing is, if he gets that kill, he effectively shuts down this tri-lane.
Snowball coming into LE, misery. Oh, there's still no skewer, and he's trying to go for the rune at the moment. And now, yeah, nighttime starts up. Misery, the Void will connect, try and juke around the tree line. Ends up just tangoing down the tree, so the vision's available. But MR doesn't really have anything to give. His Arctic Burn's on cooldown, and Spinner Blast won't do that much there. So he's more of a cold embrace saving in case things go wrong.
You know what I am considering right now? Whether or not maybe Jiajia just isn't very comfortable playing against the aggressive tri-lanes and coming back. There are certain carry players where they just, you know, they need the free farm to be able to kind of build up, and they're not used to that kind of pressure. And that might have just factored into a lot of things, but this time around, he does have free farm, and we're going to be able to see what he's able to do with it this time around. And because of the constant pressure of the Darkseer and the Nightstalker starting at top, Eternal Envy isn't doing as well as him, but it is going to be an Anti-Mage, and the Anti-Mage is going to be able to pull ahead later on as the game goes on.
Yeah. Which kind of then flags the question, when does Newbie Y start attacking? Like, Omnislash is normally a really great enabler. And up against a hero like Magnus, he doesn't have an escape mechanism to get away from that Omnislash. So both the Blade Fury as well as an Omni would end up killing off this Magnus.
Yeah,
so the opportunities are there without even having to leave the lane.
This mid lane too is going okay for the Ember Spirit. I say that even though he's down 8 CS, and the main reason for that is because it's sort of expected. Like, Weehawk can just push him back with right clicks alone, and even with the poor man's shield, it makes it pretty difficult for you to CS, because you never really want to be in the range where one gank will be able to do you in. So he's going to be primarily focused on trading CS, even if it's a little bit uneven.
Ooh. Misery actually moved off the lane for a bit. This will allow the push on bottom to come in a little bit harder. Misery skewers away, but that Omni Slash is up, and he's away from a creep wave. Okay, committal underneath tier 2 towers. Last time it didn't go too well. But they do get the rotation in from Puppy, and now Nightstalker also arrives. They don't have the silence available, but with the Splinter Blast, they can take out... Okay, not even much of the creep wave. That's a level 1 Splinter Blast. That's not doing jack. But it's going to buy a little bit more comfort room for SEC to move in the mid.
Yeah, maybe if they actually had the Night Stalker around this area, but they aren't going to be able to do too much. The Darkseer, in conjunction with the Night Stalker, might be able to do some damage.
They're coming mid. They need Weehaw to break out of this Invis.
Yeah. There, he should be right now.
Oh, well, there it is.
All right, here's your opportunity right now.
Okay, so if they get nothing. Ember Spirit, three.
He's gotta get the middle! He couldn't get the Searing Chain off, however.
Without that, they don't have the control factor. Paladai came in as quick as he possibly could, but this is a big rotation to lose out on.
That is all three remnants, fire remnants used, and you had to rotate your carry for that. And I like the rotation of the carry, because it secures the kill on the mid laner, and that's perfectly fine, but...
It gave Wyvern space at least, so he's moving closer towards having that curse.
Yeah, but that was a fairly large commitment that didn't really net you anything, because that was a smoke as well.
Yeah. But it's at least them trying something. Top lane, Darkseer, he can try and survive, running up a little bit further north. The shards off target. The blink is still a level 1, so Darkseer can wait out a little bit longer so he can try and surge out. In fact, he's going to run into the tree line, but is there a way out of here? And, okay, no, there's not. No, there definitely is not.
Yeah, he always had that up. There wasn't really an option. He started buying out as soon as that happened. He's like, there's no way that I'm getting out. It's not even really worth the attempt. It's like a half effort to just waste a little bit of time more than anything. And if you can force out the Mana Void, great. That's the best possible death scenario if you want to talk about it like that.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we kind of move back into this passive farming kind of stage. The Juggernaut as well as the Animage both working towards their Battle Furies. Maybe a little bit faster for the Animage considering Magnus, Misery to get an early level up and empower. So there's going to be a little bit of an extra buff for the AM to farm with. And Weehaw's had a pretty damn good start as well. 41 for 19. He's equal for most of the CS. In fact, there's very little difference between the lane positions. The only big difference is kind of that mid lane, whereas the 10 difference between Weehaw as well as SC.
Yeah. I think the one thing to note, though, is that the Magnus is actually getting quite a bit of farm, because what ends up happening in this scenario is that you're trying to give your Nightstalker a lot of XP and some farm, because the first night time didn't go as planned, and it went a little bit more awry than you would have liked. So you're trying to give him XP, but it's a Nightstalker against the Magnus. And the Magnus has a regen rune and arcane boots. So he's just going to constantly force him out and get more or less free XP right now. Like, Misery's doing such a good job in this lane because he recognizes, okay, neither of the supports are here. It's not that big of a deal. They're going to rotate this Jug into this mid lane, bring their carry, bring their mid over, because the Ember Spirit is one of the better heroes at ganking up that anti-mage. Mm-hmm. You notice he's gone for the three levels in the Searing Chains.
Yep.
Wants to make sure that he gets Eternal Envy with that, but...
If he's able to get an Iron Shell on him as well, so the Iron Shell, Surge, letting him run forward, but Pilot Eye's already back a long way behind the tower, so this Surge doesn't really do enough for him, but they find Pumpy instead. So straight into the Arctic Burn. You still have Shallow Grave available, and Pumpy, with the TP out, they already use Searing Chains, and they don't have enough. He'll end up surviving back at base.
That is a huge rotation that you use to kill a hero that wasn't even a core. Like, Pumpy just kind of realizes, oh, they have no stuns.
You kind of have to creep skip this out now. Like, to take out the tier 1 tower to get something for the rotation.
There, I don't even think they really get anything out of this. Like, Jia can't really pressure the Windranger out at all. Because as soon as he starts running, then you can just wind run and phase boots forward.
Mm-hmm.
And now Misery, this is the biggest proponent of all of this. Like, he's getting the most. He's level 8 right now. He's popping the regen.
He's almost got the blink dagger.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, that's an incredibly fast timing. Misery's like, okay, I'm just going to free farm down here and nobody's going to do anything. You keep rotating your cores to other lanes and great stuff.
You know, it's a problem. He's got more net worth than the Ember Spirit bottom lane. The RP, LE trying to go to work. The skewer's going to push him back over the tree line.
He's going
to
guarantee the kill
with
first.
The shockwave, he'll actually get the kill on the Nightstalker, but the Ember Spirit and Juggernaut. Again, they move together. They get the kill on the Magnus.
But this opens up the option for the mid lane now. Weeha's just going to pop his DD, try to pressure this, because he knows that the Ember Spirit TP'd for this.
But it's a tower trade-off then. The fortifications used by the Radiant side, Dai doesn't have it. So it will be a tier 1 tower for damage onto the tier 1 tower in mid. The TP's coming back to the mid lane, and LE needs to force Weeha out. Starts with a void, but we're still during daytime. So it really doesn't have the same effect. And with a double damage rune on Windranger, LE should be a little bit careful about how close he moves to these trees.
No, as long as he keeps the catapult alive, this is a free tower.
Oh, Shackle. Weeha. Void. Okay, he'll go for the silence as well. Support's not rotating in fast enough to get the control on him. So Weeha's back, and he gets the last hit in the tower.
This is going to be his point booster too, and this is going to put him over the edge when it comes to net worth over the Ember Spirit, and this is just what it means to force over rotations. Yes, you get a kill on Misery, yes, you get a tower, but most importantly, you lose your own mid tower. You give Weeha free farm space, and it wasn't even like the Magnus is super far behind.
Yep.
Look at the amount of gold that he has after they get that tower. He's about where he wanted to be. He was able to get the solo kill on the Nightstalker too. Already at 1800 gold, just 12 minutes in here. And that's the kind of timing that you expect if he goes straight for the blink. Not even with arcanes.
It's one of those heroes too you'd expect to try and get, like, try and zone him out of the lane. But to come in full with the Arctic Burn from the Wyvern, you use that Blade Fury from the Juggernaut to take out his life. But maybe why they... As you said, like with the unsuccessful rotations, and they try and give experience the Wyvern, then experience the Nightstalker. Space for the Magnus was created. There's now an invis room for the Ember Spirit, so he's got the potential to get aggressive. Interesting to see where he pops this too. You look back to the Vision game, and it's pretty deep wards from Secret. You got one that's watching near the Ancient area, and the secondary one was watching the top lane. It just timed out now. So they've planted a fresh one down in front of Roshan.
Although Secret have a very small lead built up for them, the Juggernaut still has the most in net worth. He almost has that Battle Fury. This is going to be the item that allows him to kind of keep even with the Anti-Mage, at least for a little bit. And they're going to rotate a lot of heroes up here. This type of gank, popularized by CDEC, if you get the kill, great. If you don't get anybody, that's okay too. You're going to probably just aim for the tower more than the kill itself. And you notice, they just immediately go for the tower.
Yep. I understand the puppy's not up in the tree line anymore. Take out the tier 1. Pilot's still poking around the middle lane. MR's going to soak up level 6. He's so close to doing so. But they just have to let it go. And Secret are happy to dodge the fight. Like, we're 10 p.m. in Dota time. So there's only another 2 minutes and a half left at this night time. And Secret just don't want to go into this. Like, there's no reason to either. Like, Evie wants to farm up. The Battle Fury is now done. Before the 14-minute mark. And with the Empower buff up, he just goes straight through this quad stack of Ancients. Very, very quickly.
Yeah, now he's going to get ahead of the Juggernaut, and as long as they don't lose any significant towers or fights, this is where he should stay.
Maybe that's when newbie, why have to start asking the question, because EE rotated off that top lane before the push came. You talked about the fact that CDEC really made this a big thing during TI. Newbie, why have been compared to CDEC as far as game style goes too?
They've got...
So Secret read newbie's rotation.
They've got a lot of different ways, though, to deal with the Anti-Mage. You have the Chains, you've got the Winter's Curse, you have the Night Stalker Silence, you've got the Darkseer Vacuum Wall. So it's not as if... I think it was yesterday's EG game where they had almost no answers to the Anti-Mage against Fnatic. It's not like that game at all. This time they have a lot better responses. They have a good mix of physical and magic damage, so they don't have to worry too much yet, but something they should be concerned about is Misery now is his Blink Dagger. You've got a lot of levels on this offlane Magnus, who actually has more farm than a Darkseer, which is pretty rare to see. And most importantly, there's a lot of natural synergy just between the Anti-Mage and the Magnus.
And Ellie's very aggressively moving over to Secret. He's still got 1 minute of nighttime left. Weeha hiding in the tree line. And the Wii pops off from the Dazzle. It triggers on the edge of the Nightstalker, as well as the Ember Spirit. So they're both losing armor fairly quickly, and Weeha is just... Like, he's power shotting from range, doesn't want to get involved in any of these fights. Because they're also getting the trade-off. Paradise attacking up on the top lane, and that's where SD comes in. He wants his kill on the Tusker. Snowball will protect him for a little bit. There's a whole lot of heroes poised to attack him mid, but SD wants this kill, and now he can come back and join the rest of his team. But Misery, he's waiting for it in the tree line. That Blink Dagger now on cooldown, because SD's on top of him. They skewer up to the high ground. There goes your ulti, but what really is left? SD with the Iron Shell on him too. This burns through the Magnus' life. And that was meant to be their big initiation, SD making plays on both sides of the map.
I don't even know if that's making plays, because he had the Flame Guard plus the Ion Shell on him, and Misery just pops the ultimate, but there's almost no chance that he's going to be able to set up for anything there. Nobody from his team is quite nearby. The Ember Spirit is still at nearly full HP, and although his mana is a little bit low, it's not too big of a concern for him right now because of how much health he has, and everybody's there backing him up. So you don't get the mid tower, but you do pick up two free kills, one in top, one in mid.
Quite substantial as well, because now Pylai die. He doesn't have his initiation either. He's a level 7 Tusker, but it sticks arcanes, and that's all for now. And he's not the sacrificial one. He's meant to be that fourth position. Puppy is the one sacrificing himself. But they're both pretty much equal for the net worth, and looks like Secret now. Well, if you're feeling a little bit behind going for Roshan, the Observer Ward's down, but it doesn't see them because they were smoked up as they moved in. But that Vladimir's offering from Anti-Mage is making this a little bit more possible.
I don't think there's any chance that Newbie Young know about this.
If Ember Spirit moved these illusions a little bit earlier on, he would have scouted this out, but they were sitting on top of the camp and now they move a little too late. So Roshan's dumb, and Anti-Mage will be picking up that Aegis the Immortal.
Yeah, there's very little chance at that phase, even if you scout it out. Your team's just not in position. You have no idea where Secret is positioned around the Roche Pit. You do have that one ward available, but you don't get to peek into the high ground area of the Ancients. So there's almost zero chance that you take that fight. Because you know that the Magnus now can just skewer you on the cliffs and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be concerned.
They're taking a fight into the Aegis the Immortal, however. So they get the Iron Shell over on the Ember Spirit, surging him up. There's an opening over on Weeha and Weeha. Well, he's still got Windrun available and SC. He's inching forward. They'll go to the high ground and Misery. Well, he turned up Death Alley right now. The skewer down. The RP is back off cooldown, but the curse is dragging him in on top of Weeha. The Darkseer wall will get the last bit of damage, and they'll take out two. The snowball from Pylai, they actually strand him underneath his own tier 2 tower with the Omni Slash mopping him up. Three heroes down from Secret, and Newbie Y take yet again another great fight. They defend the top tower, boot, and take the mid tier 1.
Yeah, and most importantly, they don't give up any sort of pressure to Eternal Envy. He's going to get a free kill over here, and
oh, really?
Not even...
He'll blink forward. Okay, he'll take it, but is it really free?
This crippling fear of Valbus, they go for the silence, the quick rotation, and nope, there goes Euregus the Immortal. They don't have another control yet. Searing Chain is 1 second off cooldown, and they actually got it! They cancel the TP!
One more hit!
Down! Oh my! Oh my, oh my, oh my!
That's a killing spree too, that goes on the Juggernaut. He's got a Yasha now, and everything just sort of turns around for newbie Young. They pop the Aegis, they get a kill on the Anti-Mage. That's two cores down that you were previously worried about. And you don't even lose the tower. And all that it costs you is a Winter Wyvern. Newbie Young are going to feel so confident right now. The net worth lead is still in favor of the Anti-Mage.
But this is the first time that Newbie Y... This is the first time Newbie Y have had an experience lead in 18 minutes out of a 19-minute game. They brought the gold back to zero as well. Secret's advantage has just disappeared.
Yeah, whatever they built up in the Roshan is almost entirely dissipated.
Yep.
And now they're going to start playing aggressively for this mid tower. I think they're going to feel pretty emboldened with how the engagement
is. Oh, nice shackle. SC taking too much damage, but the Cold Embrace and the mech is already up.
That's going to play a pretty big role in this game. The Cold Embrace against the Windranger. You don't have any burst nuke damage on the side of Team Secret. They don't have a hero like
They're going for another kill. Paladai was trying to deboard, and SC just runs himself forward. The Iron Shell is out, and Paladai burning himself. The back will come. It's a good RP.
Oh.
There's a curse. It traps Misery. Weeha couldn't get the attack off. And now it's Puppy. Shell Upgrade's available. He'll keep Misery alive for just a little bit longer, but that's not going to be his path of out. They'll end up losing two heroes Secret again and deep their tier 2 tower. They commit the RP for that one, and now the tier 1 tower will properly die.
It almost looked like he just skewered him even into a better Winter's Curse. I know that wasn't the point, but...
because it grabbed Weeha.
Yeah,
it
looked really clowny, but luckily nobody else dies. Eternal Envy is committed, and something I really want to point out is that every single time they go for these engagements, Eternal Envy has to rotate, and he's not going for the split push because he feels like he has to be there for these engagements, meaning that he's not getting any more out of these engagements. Like, usually what ends up happening is the Anti-Mage continues to split up, continues to push the issue, but because of the way the aggression is going, Newbie Young aren't really giving up anything for these single kills.
Now look at the big drawing coming out. Okay, Puppy. He came on a mission from God to try and get that Observer Ward down so they could understand where Newbie Y are moving inside the Dire Jungle. Because right now, EE is isolated to the Radiant side. He can't go anywhere else.
That's where you're supposed to go, though.
Yeah.
You almost never play on your side of the jungle at this phase of the game because you want the option to be able to just go straight for this tier 2 at bottom. But Newbie Young,
look,
they're going to go for their own. And
the Shackle won't be out of latch. Weeha steering chained up. They don't have enough control on him, however. The Vac will drag him back down,
I think,
and
they
maybe
have him.
They do. Weeha a little bit too far out. The Urn's giving the extra damage, but the Iron Shell didn't do enough work. Defensive Spirit will allow Ember Spirit to get out from underneath the tier 3 tower. So this time, Newbie Y, with their aggression, do not find Blood of Secret.
Well, they don't even take a little bit over aggressive there.
Just a little bit.
But you want to start to, you want to continue to press the issue. You have the nighttime, you've got a lot of the momentum, and that's something that you don't want to give up. You're not killing Eternal Envy during this time, so you want to try to just get as much as you can out of the sides of the map. Once Eternal Envy gets his Manta style, it's going to be quite
difficult. Oh, Misery! The RP was used, but the Slider Fist dodge was there!
That's actually godlike. Oh boy.
You know Misery's gonna be quick. Finally, Newbie Y, for the first time in a long time, they've got vision on Eternal Envy. They put down an aggressive Observer Ward. And this is now down to Secret too. Like, they've got one Obs and one Sentry available. They don't have the money in their supports to keep playing the vision game, and now they may even lose Weeha. The curse will try and hold him here. The ice shards do keep out SC, but now Pylai die with the walrus punch, so they're backing back in again. The Darkseer wall won't do enough, and SC doesn't get up the hill with the spirit. Not the greatest positioning in the world, but with the void, they ensure the kill on Pylai die. Envy continues to elude the Juggernaut in the top lane. But Newbie Y, they keep the pressure up. And now they come to attack the tier 2 tower. And all Envy can do is do what I... Actually, no, he's blinking in deeper. He's not creep skipping up this wave. He'll creep skip the next one.
Yeah, he wants to make sure that all 5 heroes are up here because he doesn't have the item that he covets so much in that Manta. Without that Manta, he can't really afford to just show himself. The Battle Fury is now completed, though, for this Ember Spirit at 23 minutes. This dual core setup that Newbie Young are running is proving to be so successful. They've got the Blink Dagger and the mech completed now. onto Lee, and Ellie himself almost has that Aghanim Scepter now. And you're talking about aggression. You're going to ramp that thing up to 12 once he gets that completed.
It's a crazy situation. Can I get hyped now, Blitz? Can I have permission to be hyped about newbie Y?
I would settle down for a little bit because even though they're up 4,000 gold, you still got the ramp potential of the anti-mage.
True.
And the game isn't quite over yet. Yeah, but I would wait a second before I crown
I won't, Young, but... I won't disagree with you. The mana style now being up for AM gives him a way to get out of this fight if he does get silenced up. He almost puts more pressure on the Wyvern, doesn't it? Like, because that curse is the primary thing to control him.
Yeah. He's got to make sure when he uses his Manta that both of those disables have been used at some point. The silence and the chains.
Yep.
He has to make absolute sure of that, but... And you can start getting hyped after this next team fight because newbie Young, they do have the advantage.
They're dodging it. They're dodging it for now. MR's trying to find the opening by going into that Arctic Burn, but it's the bottom lane push. Tier 2 tower for Team Secret and newbie White. Actually, they've still got fortification to get through and they're running out of their creep wave, so... Okay, backdoor protection will finally turn off, so this Juggernaut can finish what he started. Weeha, Slight of Fist Searing Chain. There's only one unit in that Slight of Fist. It's still a Searing Chain, but Secret, they've come up. They've gone up towards the Tier 3 tower. The Juggernaut will come back. They still got the Tier 2 tower in the mid. The Catapult took it out. Oh, actually, nope, there it goes. Tuskar takes it out. Catapult doesn't survive long enough.
You just traded a Tier 2 for a Tier 2. That's definitely in favor of Team Secret. If not only for the deny, but the fact that you created more space. So the next time Eternal Envy decides to go for one of these split pushes, you're already at the base. And so this is what newbie Young have to worry about at all times. If we leave our base, are we giving the anti-mage a little bit too much? Because when they were going for the pressure, they often found him in the jungle, in the safe lane, and they were able to get some kills. But with this Manta available to him, now things are going to get pretty difficult.
How do you even catch him out? Like it's almost like everything we're talking about has to happen during a big team fight, which AM is part of.
You pretty much just have to force out all the lanes, make sure that he feels some amount of pressure, and then you want to go for just forced engagements. The problem though is that Team Secret, you've got some good high ground defense in that you don't want to just get RP'd by multiple heroes. And the Juggernaut does okay when it comes to base sieging, but the Ember Spirit adds almost nothing, and he's your second highest net worth hero. And you want to be careful, because we've seen what Weeha can do with those Shackle shots.
He's also got a fresh Blink Dagger on Weeha too, so not just Shackles, but the repositioning to make the Shackles work.
Yeah, they're going to sit behind this Anti-Mage though, and Team Secret trying to assert themselves on the map a little bit and say to themselves, Eternal Envy, you've got a Manta. It's going to be pretty hard for you to die. Just bait yourself a little bit. But I think newbie Young know that, and they're not even going to bother. They're saying to themselves, well, the Anti-Mage, he's pretty much unkillable. Let's just make sure that we clear out everything that we need to clear out first. Get some more farm on our Anti-Mage, or on our Juggernaut and our Ember Spirit.
I look more towards the Nightstalker too. Get that Aghanim Scepter up and running for him. That's why they're giving him the top lane. A lot of space.
Yeah, four-man smoke. Misery's going to be here to tank the smoke.
That's an invis rune from SC. He finds Misery. There's no one else around him. They're over towards Roshan, and SC moves forward. He gets a double side of Fist Searing Chains on Weeha and Pylai die. Misery skewering himself away, and now the Juggernaut. There's no creep wave there. Omni slashes. Misery's down for the count.
Oh, it's now on Weeha!
Try and find more, and there's actually another one! Weeha's down as well! The Ember Spirit's going in deeper. Pylai has to hide inside the pit to TP out, but what's Envy really able to do? The Mana Void doesn't do enough. The fight got completely split. Secret were in three different areas when that started.
And
the only thing
that
would make
up,
this in one minute, they have time at least. Team Secret.
Still, that Omni Slash actually just blew the door off the hinges. He was able to kill the Magnus in full, without Misery being able to get that RP off, and most importantly, it transfers over to Weeha and gets him killed too. Just absolutely brutal. Maybe they could have even gone for the high ground if they were able to go for that Aegis, but. Unable to do so, and you don't even have to kill Eternal Envy if you're finding engagements like this.
You really don't. The Juggernaut keeps getting bigger. MR will back out. They still didn't take the big objective after it, and Secret, in fact, are running down towards Roshan. While the Spirit's sitting inside the pit, this will allow newbie Y to know exactly when Roshan spawns up and make Secret look behind themselves all the time.
Oh,
and
he
now,
blinks out.
Well, yep, blink down. He's still got that Spirit down inside the pit, didn't have to use it. And Secret, after this smoke, don't find anything.
SC is just clowning on them with his reaction time, being able to blink out of there.
First
that one wasn't as hard, but They know for sure that the Roshan is happening now. He's got the spirit in there.
Can he jump?
They've got to hurry.
They're coming. They're coming into smoke. But Roshan's already down to 3k, 2k. Make it 1k. They won't get there in time. MSB jumps in. Anyways, gets the Aegis Immortal. It's killed by
the he's going to get blown up.
He's down. One man on the sideline. The Juggernaut had to disengage. He didn't have Omni Slash. They're still on cooldown for 4 more seconds. And where's your initiation? It's MR battling up against Misery and Weeha. The Cold Embrace will buy a little bit of time, but it won't save his life here. The power shot ensures the kill, but he really just went for it. He gave it a crack, and it failed.
He thought he had enough time to get the next spirit on the way over, but unable to do so. And maybe if he was able to do that, even with the Aegis, they could have taken that team fight. Because Eternal Envy isn't in scary territory yet. Like, with the Manta style, it's defensive, but he can't really afford to use that offensively because they will kill him twice.
Yep.
So oftentimes what you're going to see is the anti-mage just kind of passively hitting along, going to wait for the abilities to channel out first. But not really as scary.
He is at scary territory with another 5k sitting in his inventory.
Yeah, that's where things become a little bit rough because once he's in fighting shape, Yubi Young are going to struggle.
Okay, yeah. Juggernaut did move. You got scattered by the power shot and just stood there for half a second.
That was a pretty big kill spree that they gave up on the Ember Spirit, though. And most importantly, they slowed down the momentum. They got the Aegis for themselves right under the noses of Yubi Young. And I think that was a small mistake by them. They should have been in position, especially with that spirit in.
Yeah.
Once that gank failed, they have to know, oh, Secret are probably going to go with that Roshan.
The interesting thing is the kill went the way of Pylai Dai. He got the extra cash, but it's so big that he got it because it's allowing him to complete up the mech for Team Secret. So they're getting a little bit more sustain into these fights on top of what Dazzle already provides.
Yeah, you've almost got the butterfly completed on Eternal Envy. He's
so got no, by the you got room. No direct hits into the anti-mage.
All right, SC, you've got to get out of there.
So does the Wyvern. But Wyvern wants to keep farming. He's inching close towards that Blink Dagger. It's the Juggernaut. The snowball's coming towards him. He'll start up his spin. And now, in fact, blinks away from Pylai Dai and the rest of Team Secret who showed themselves in the mid lane now. All ultis are up, and we are still during nighttime, but the Aghanim set the stun for the Nightstalker. So Newbie Y at least have a vision advantage here. And they try and get a little bit more. Even the bottom lane, putting that Observer on the hillside. They're preparing to come and fight in this bottom lane. Team Secret can take out the tier 2 tower, sure, but you... Wow, okay. Envy, aggressive Manta-style attack. He's still got the Aegis Immortal, so you can't blame him for it.
You saw Weeha go for the Ghost Scepter. Understands that the only thing that's really killing him is the physical damage here. There's also no sort of magic burst damage coming the way of Yubi Young. And Yubi Young, though, they're a little bit more tentative, especially after that engagement where they lost their Ember Spirit. You don't really want to fight against an Aegis Anti-Mage. You're giving up a Tier 2 and a Tier 1, but at least it's not the game, right?
Do they try and actually defend the Tier 2?
I don't. The problem is, if you go for that engagement and you lose, the creep wave is right there, so you probably lose Rax. And that's what you have to assert.
This might be a little bit better, however. That Nightstalker is giving vision on the Animage, and he just blinks down. They know there's no one else behind the Animage. But really, all. Like, it's like all Envy seems to be doing is trying to be a sponge. Soak up any abilities that Newbie Y have. Because what's the chance of them killing him twice over?
Like I talked about, is it worth your tier 2 to potentially just lose the game?
No.
Yubi Young are going to say, nope, there's no way that we're going to defend that one.
But they have to defend them. This. They have to hold this. There's no choice. There's still another one and a half, well, just over 1 minute left on that Aegis the Immortal. Well, a slight of Fist-searing chains. And he is forced to blink himself away. I'll lose the catapult as well. And this is all just, like, wasting time for him. Another side of Fist takes out most of the creep wave with a Splinter Blast too. But Envy will finish the tier 3 tower. He really wants to go for more, but he's got to be careful. With 1 minute left on the Aegis. Okay, the Shackle, it got SC! That's huge right now! They need to buy space to Darkseer! Backwall catches out 3, the Mana Void! However, Darkseer and Wyvern just get destroyed! Team Secret, that's the huge fight they wanted! A double buyback coming out from Newbie Y to try and defend their ranks. The Juggernaut to the front lines, but no Omni Slash
to
Bubble!
The Jug's gonna go down so fast!
So quickly, 70 seconds, no buyback available. Wyvern will use his, but there's so much weight on the remaining 4 plays of Newbie Y.
die. Can they defend it? Envy still here, waiting it out. We are taking huge amounts of damage at the back line. He needs to escape from this one. The Shackle won't control long enough. The Sight of Fist from SC. He'll bring down Weeha. 3 heroes down for Secret for now. But how's that Animage looking? Up and away. Mana Styles to block out the exit. And he will be able to retreat. He's only got a couple of seconds left on the Aegis, but it's the perfect timing. He's out to safety. They took out the melee racks and a huge amount of buybacks. 3 of them in total from Newbie Y.
And so difficult for them to pressure Eternal Envy whatsoever. And he's just not afraid anymore. He understands that with the Butterfly and the Manta, as long as he plays the fight correctly, it's nearly impossible for them to cut through him. They didn't even get through half his HP pull before his team just got absolutely destroyed. Weeha was able to just put out insane amounts of damage with just the Blink Dagger and the Aghanim Scepter. And now that he's got the crit as well, you've got to be so worried if you're Newbie Young. At some point, it looks so good for them too. But they just weren't able to ever kill that Anti-Mage, and giving up that Aegis proved to mean so much to them.
Emma. Envy just needs to get... Well, what else he got? Okay, yeah, that TP's not going to work. No Wyvern for a minute. This Blink Dagger is becoming a thought. That was very long past.
You can't lose Lee here. He doesn't have the buyback available.
Oh, the Mana Void so early. Just going to go for the mini stun. Trying to slow him down. He can't juke forever. The fact he goes for the three-man wall with a Sleight of Fist. Poppy takes big damage, but Shallowgrave will allow him to survive the last attack from the Dazzle Illusion from the wall. Doesn't do the work. The Sleight of Fist earring chains Poppy. Now he will die. So you get something in return, but it's very little. That's 6.1k already back onto the Animage, and he's double buffed. The Empower plus Battle Fury, he's just ready to go.
Yeah, he's no longer afraid of anything. Now he's gonna just blink back, wait things out a little bit. There's no reason to fight without your Shallow Grave. You're in such a commanding position right now because the Juggernaut doesn't even have that MKB yet. The item progression for the Ember Spirit has effectively ended because he had to go for that buyback earlier in the game. And now things look pretty grim for Newbie Young as Roche Control is firmly in the hands of Team Secret.
And one more Aegis will be enough confidence for the AM to go forward. Like, he's got his BKB now, so 10 seconds of worth of magic immunity for him. Another way to break free as well. Not only the Manta, but the BKB to disjoint. They just move forward. Just AM Illusion scouting out the movement of Newbie Y. This was the ticking time bomb that Newbie Y let explode. Like, their entire lineup was working so well, but you kept saying it, like, you don't want to get excited too much because you're still going to worry about what happens when the AM gets online.
He's got a BKB now, and if you couldn't kill him before, the BKB is going to make it infinitely harder. No longer will you have the Searing Chains. The only thing that can really disrupt you anymore is the Winner's Curse.
But the Wyvern can't get to his Blink Dagger in time. He's been trying for the last 10-15 minutes.
They're just making sure that they have control of the rush pit so that Newbie Young, if they decide to go for a sneak attempt, they can't just do it with the Juggernaut plus two. Mm-hmm. You want to guarantee that you get the Aegis for yourself. Make absolute sure that there's no real way for them to sneak back into this game like Team Secret did.
Speaking of the Juggernaut, he's finished his Monkey King bar. So with the Monkey King bar up, they do have some direct damage going into the Anti-Mage. So he's not the big immortal he was previously. And with the Aghanim Scepter, now Envy doesn't see him at all. They see him perfectly. So if they can find the opening, realize he runs down the river, they need that control. There goes the Mana
Styles. Oh, they get the chains!
And now with the curse, they're gonna catch him out. Force up the hill, and sees the man fighting him, but Envy just does too much damage to him. The shards are gonna lock Lee up on the low ground. As looks like Secret. Oh, where else they got? It's just the Night Stalker. That's the gem as well. Night Stalker down for the count. Team Secret get another kill. They have to wait for Roshan's. Almost again, the maximum 3-minute duration.
They simply just didn't have enough in the tank right there. I think maybe if the Juggernaut can get his ultimate off onto the Anti-Mage while they're Winner's Cursing, they have an opportunity. But even then, things are pretty rough in this fight.
They really are. No curse for a minute. They don't have the abilities to try and fight this. Like, you can slide a fierce Searing Chain, try and control the AM. No BKB at least up for the Animage. That's your upside here. but you need that big creep wave forward. So SC with the Slide of Fist can do some terrible damage. And now the VAC will come in. The Slide of Fist goes to work. Puppy self-graves himself. And they back out. Weehar as well on the run. They need more control. The Slide of Fist can't work with a Searing Chain. In fact, he didn't just pop the Searing Chain. It's just the basic Slide of Fist. And Secret, they come in again. Because it's 20 seconds away now. Same for the Darkseer Wall.
No, I think you just go for the Aegis. There's actually no reason not to. They know that it's going to respawn at any moment. They're willing to wait that out just to try to grab the Aegis. Eternal Envy. He's got a Basher on the chicken now too, but you just wait things out.
Yeah.
There's no reason to force it, because if you lose that fight, then it gives Newbie Young an objective to go for themselves. They can just go for the Aegis, try to get it onto their Ember Spirit. So you want to make sure that you grab it for yourself before anything happens. The duration is going to make them a little bit antsy, but it should be okay.
Roshan still hasn't spawned yet.
Oh, they're going to try to get control before it comes up.
Night Stalker's in there. The Dire Observer one saw him run in, and they can just kill off the NS. He walks out of the pit, but Snowball, the back will come in with the wall as well. Weehar focusing down over on LE. The Shards will make sure he's got nowhere to run while Puppy. Well, SC does get a Slide of Fist off. Roshan's up and running. And Puppy, well, it's the AM party, the back lines. He brings down the Juggernaut as this fight becomes insanely split for Misery. He's even chasing after this Darkseer. He won't be able to reach him, but RP hasn't been used. Three heroes down for Newbie. Why? And Secret know that Roshan's ready. They'll have to walk through the Darkseer wall unless they just want to blink over. In fact, that's exactly what EE does.
We're talking about this Aegis and Cheese, but do they even really need it?
No. They really don't. They're showing they can just win these fights time and time again.
Do they even need the RP at this point? I don't think Misery's even had to use one for them to be in a successful engagement. Eternal Envy's just so farmed right now that what ends up happening in the beginning of the fight is he just goes in, kills like two people by himself, and then Misery's just kind of sitting there thinking to himself, all right, what is my contribution here? 28k net worth. He was picked off early, but none of that anymore, as he's 9-1-2 and fairly unstoppable.
It's a beast. It's a BCE. On the back of it, it looks like Secret will be able to push themselves forward to a matchup. Yes, the winner of LGD and Cloud9, MR. So much damage from Weehar, the power shot ensures it. There's no way to call it Embrace, and now there's your RP. The back can't control enough. That's the game right there with a big RP. No Ember Spirit for a minute and a half. They just go directly for the GG push. Team Secret, they got a scare. They got a big scare. Even in this game, Newbie Y were getting a big advantage time and time again. But it just won't be enough. Secret will triumph 2-1.
I thought the game, it was incredibly exciting because there were opportunities that you saw where Newbie Young could have really won that game. But giving up the Roshan for free, then losing that pivotal fight right after that,